So today I want to talk to you about three really fundamental things when we're talking about sculpting and learning to sculpt anatomy. One is drawing, and I've mentioned this many times. Very important to recognize the need for drawing and to draw well enough to render your ideas onto paper. And then the other thing would be observation. The willingness to just observe quietly without projecting human emotion upon your subject, just observing what is there in truth and identifying what the subject is doing and how it's interacting with its environment, and not making assumptions about those interactions or not projecting what you might feel. Rather, just observing what's taking place, nothing more. So that's a skill that is learned, because we tend as humans to really identify with our own experiences and then project that onto whomever we are interacting with or observing. So we want to learn to remove those emotions and observe truthfully what is happening in front of us with our subject. And then we want to learn to measure proportions accurately. And there's lots of ways that you can learn to do the measuring of proportions. Some of the most accurate are utilizing relative proportion. That might be utilizing the golden ratio. So when we're applying the drawing techniques, there are some fundamental techniques that you would want to learn to really help you your journey along, and to help you be more successful in rendering the subject that you want to render. And also, with specific techniques, you can expedite the process. So learning specific fundamental techniques in art will help you not only enjoy it more, but also help you create better and more accurate artwork, which helps in studying the anatomy accurately, which is ultimately what we want to do here at Sculpture Equine Anatomy. And then in this process, of course, there's a need for observation, right? We have to observe the subject so that we can render it truthfully, like I said. And not only the interactions of what our subject might be doing, but also the physical makeup of that subject. How do shapes and forms come together? How does the volume within those shapes and forms shape the figure itself? How shadow changes the structure? So we want to be aware of what is true to the body of the subject and what might be distorted based on what we're seeing and the shadows that are being cast based on the light and the time of day and the location. So there's lots of elements that come into the preparation of sculpting, and it's very exciting because it's the time of investigation. It's where we're learning a lot about our subject. We are investigating, like I said, to really come to a truthful understanding of the physical makeup. You can identify the developmental stages of the horse, where that horse might be at, or where your subject might be at in its life, if it's a sport animal or not, how those muscles are formed, how they are exercise is going to change the contours found within the body. So all of this comes together as we're preparing to sculpt the anatomy. The observation from life is really essential, and this is where we bring all of the elements of studying anatomy into play. It's where we're able to utilize it in our daily lives and apply it in a way that is useful and helpful to the well-being of the horse and to the safety and well-being of the rider. So I hope these three fundamental points help you in your starting this new journey. You can seek out different masters. There's lots of people that teach drawing online. You can join my free drawing course that teaches you the anatomical terms of the anatomy of the horse. And there you will also learn the really basic starting points to some drawing of anatomy as well. So if you like this video, make sure that you hit the subscribe button down below. Give me a thumbs up, share it with your friends, help them learn anatomy. This is really, really vital for us to learn so that we can keep our horses safe, keep them healthy long term, and really help ourselves also in being safe and healthy, and changing the equestrian community, because change comes from knowledge. It comes from sharing that knowledge and being helpful to one another and lifting up one another up and being supportive. So please subscribe, share, and comment down below. Thank you so much.